Our soccer weekly update on GoJacks.com. We'll get to head coach Brock Thompson. Leah Manuleleua joining us first. Last night, big win over Hawai'i. Take me through the goal in the final few minutes and kind of an awkward play. Had to stay with it after an initial stop by them. So tell me about it.
Well, Maya, she had the ball and I think she had won it back. But she's really good at isolating people and taking the 1v1. So I knew she was going to get it in. And then initially, the goalie had really covered front post really well, looking back at it again. And so, I mean, I just got the ball, and then I went for it again. I was like, got to score this one.
You make it sound so simple, Leah. In the case of the last couple weeks, you just needed something positive. How important was that to get some positive vibes last night?
I think it was really important, especially having three games this week and just needing a little momentum to get us going, in a sense, after a couple losses. So I think it was really important not only to get a goal, but to get a win and to just feel good about it.
What is the best part at this point from that win on Tuesday night? What do you take away from that?
I feel like just like the energy in our games have been good despite our losses. So just having a win and getting a result from it is like feels really good for like our whole team. And I feel like it's going to carry us into the rest of the season.
Let's go to the head coach, Brock Thompson, and we talked about it with Leah as well, but you needed that. You needed some positive vibes, needed a win, and you got that last night. That's a big step forward for your program.
Yeah, happy for the players and certainly happy for our team. What people don't see is kind of the leadership behind the scenes, and it was a rough stretch for us as far as just the ways the game went and some really unique adversity we had to deal with, whether that was kind of a fluky goal in the Drake game or a red card against Craig, just different things than teams typically have to deal with. And I'm really proud of the leadership group within our team that they just trusted the process, came to training every day about getting better and just kind of believed that it was what lies ahead. And certainly last night was a step of what lies ahead. Certainly we all know that it's never a smooth path, and that's what we all love about sports. But really, really proud of Leah and some of the other seniors, but really the whole leadership group on the team as a whole.
We had talked going into the year that you would be capable of some big things offensively if everything came together. Are you, I don't know if caught off guard, surprised is the right terminology, but defensively, how the team has played? Because we talked about the offense a lot coming into the year.
Yeah, you could probably overlay that interview with where we're at in the season, and certainly it would not make me look great. The piece that I like about our team is we're creating chances. I felt like we had a chance to score 2 minutes into the game or 30 seconds into the game from that standpoint. And I think we're still a little ways away defensively. I think having a goalkeeper like Maggie covers some of those little lapses. We're maybe giving up more chances than we typically do. Credit to Maggie that she's bailing us out of some of those moments a little bit. But we're making progress on that side of the ball as well. And when we talk about defending, it's really a team effort. And I think that's where we're getting better, is our forwards are actually defending better, our midfielders are defending better, and our backs are getting experience in some of these games and in some of these game-like situations.
And offensively, you don't feel like you haven't had opportunities, you just feel like the ball hasn't gone into the back of the net.
Right, and I think that's the biggest thing. You know, as a coach, I would worry more if we're not getting chances, because that's a harder fix than being able to convert the chances that you get. And so we've got goal scorers. You know, Leah's a goal scorer, Maya's a goal scorer, Abigail, Eden, they all can score, as well as some of our midfielders. We just got to stick with the process and understand that it will come. And truthfully, you'd rather go through this stretch at the beginning of the year than the end of the year or the middle of the year from that standpoint. So I still think there's really bright things ahead for our team as far as scoring goals and attacking, and we continue to make progress that way. And last night's goal was kind of a testament to that. Maya beat a player and put a ball in a really dangerous area, and Leah's persistence stuck with it and scored the game winner.
Friday, another home contest as you continue your quest to touch every conference west of the Mississippi River, as you'll see a big sky foe in eastern Washington. Give us a little preview of what the Eagles bring on Friday to Fishback.
Yeah, very, very competitive team, a very physical team. Kind of the almost a polar opposite as far as how Hawai'i plays. So it will be a really unique transition for us. They'll play a little bit more direct. Their forwards are really dynamic and dangerous. And, you know, Hawai'i kind of gave our defenders time and space on the ball. Eastern Washington will press those players and try to turn our defenders over and create chances that way. So it, from a preparation standpoint, it's probably much different than the game against Hawai'i. And I think that's okay, because I think the reality of it is I think the prep for Eastern Washington and Minnesota will probably be fairly similar as far as how they're going to, both teams are going to press us from that standpoint. So in that situation, it'll be a pretty good way for us to get ready for the weekend as a whole.
Yeah, and let's talk about Minnesota coming up too. What, again, a challenging week, as Leah talked about too, with three events.
Yeah, it's not, it's atypical for sure. And, you know, I know that as a player, you're going to love the games, right? You're going to love being able to just play, recover. But the task at hand is monumental, being able to play three games at the level that we ask our players to play at from a physicality standpoint and really a mentality standpoint. And it's a big week for us as far as growing into that and being able to end with a Big Ten team on the road on a Sunday. That will be a big challenge, but I'm excited to see how our players respond. They'll be ready for it, and I know they'll be excited for it. They always are excited to go and play in that stadium against the Gophers.
Last point, in honor of this being the 20th year of South Dakota State University soccer, you've worked with some of the folks here in the communication side of the house to put together a neat little event, and I'll let you talk about it.
Yeah, so it's crazy to think that we're celebrating our 20th season as far as soccer goes on this campus, but great, you know, October 6th, we're going to kind of celebrate all 20 seasons and kind of have an alumni day at Fishback. But one of the things in conjunction with that that we're doing is we're announcing and voting on an all-time starting 11. And so that was released this week, the ballot. And it's been really neat to kind of see the alumni base excited about it. And the response has been phenomenal. And I think it's a really neat thing. And just looking at the players that have come through the program, what a humbling kind of just list of people that the Jackrabbit soccer has produced. Obviously great players in their own right, in their own day, but unbelievable people, and it's a great opportunity to celebrate that. I think it's a great week to release that, because we've got, as you mentioned, we've got three games this week. Thursday is one day for state. It's an incredibly exciting time on this campus, and it's just neat that soccer's a piece of that.